Dear students, in the previous class I explained the algebraic structures, group structure, ring structure and field structure. So particularly, what is the field structure? A field structure is set of values on which we can perform the addition and multiplication operations, and both operations should satisfy all the five properties of the algebraic structures. What are the five properties of the algebraic structures? It should satisfy the closure property, associativity property, commutative property, existence of identity property, existence of inverse property. So in the case of the field structure, the both operations are satisfying the all the five properties. So example for the field is, what is the example for the field? The set of real numbers is one of the example for the fields. And another example for the field is a set of residues of the prime numbers, that is the ZP. So what is the ZP? ZP is the set of residues of a prime number, prime integer. For example, consider this ZP. ZP is an example for a field. ZP is an example for the field. So if ZP is a set which is a field, that should satisfy the addition operation and multiplication operations, and both should satisfy all the five properties. Now what is the ZP? So ZP is set of residues of a prime number. For example, if the prime number, consider a prime number 5, Z5. That means it contains the residues from 0 to 4. Residues from 0 to 4 only. Now, before going to check this set Z5 with the elements 0 to 1, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, if you apply the addition operation on these set of values, whether the addition satisfies all the five properties or not. First, check the closure property. For example, if you add any of these two numbers, for example, 1 plus 4, your answer is, what is the answer, what is the 1 plus 4? Actually, 1 plus 4 is, answer is 5, but since these are the residues and modulus is 5 mod 5, so answer is 0. So you got the, if you add 1 and 4 elements from this set, 1 and 4 from this set, you get the 0. So 0 is in the same set. That's why it satisfies the closure property. Similarly, check whether it satisfies associative property. For example, 0 plus 1, this one. 0, or otherwise consider 1. 1 plus 2 plus 3. Is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3. Yes, it satisfies this property. For example, this is 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 mod 5 is 0. So 1 plus 0 is, answer is 1. Come to this side. 3 plus 3, answer is 6. 6 mod 5 is 1. So answer. So it satisfies the associative property. Similarly, it also satisfies the identity property. Since the identity element in the addition operation is zero, any element in this set, any element in this set adding with zero will get the same element. So it satisfies the this one. And check it satisfies associative property or not. Yes, 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2. It satisfies the commutative property also. And check whether it satisfies the inverse property. So this is the important thing. How to check the inverse property? If you wanted to check the inverse property, you should know what are the additive inverses of these numbers in this set. What is the additive inverse for 0? You should know. What is the additive inverse for 1? Additive inverse of 2? All these you should know. So to get the additive inverse, by using the additive inverse table, we will get this one. So to get these values, first you take the 0 to 4 in the rows and 0 to 4 as the column headings. So if you add this row and columns simultaneously, you will get these values. So 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you add 2 plus 1, 3 like this. And at the time of adding, if the value is greater than the 4, if you get any value which is greater than 4, you should modulo divide that with the 5. For example, here, 1 plus 4 is actually 5, but here it is 5 because 1 plus 4 equal to 5, 1 plus 4 equal to 5, which is modulo divided with 5 means remainder is 0. That's why all the values are within the 4 only. Okay. Now additive inverses means in these row and column values, so whatever, wherever the you get the zeros, those row and columns are the additive inverse. So for 0, the additive inverse is 0. For 1, it is, here it is the 0. So for 1, the additive inverse is 4. For 2, here it is 0. That's why for 2, the additive inverse is the 3. Again, for 3, the additive inverse is 2. The additive inverse is 4. So these are the additive inverse. For 0, it is 0. For 1, it is 4. It is, for 2, it is 3. Now check whether the inverse property satisfies or not. For example, if you take any element from this set, that 5, for example, 3. Now, if you add 3 with its additive inverse. So what is the additive inverse for 3? As per this table, additive inverse for the 3 is 2. So 3, it's a 3 inverse in this table. You should get the 0. So 3 plus additive inverse of 3 in this table. So 3's additive inverse is 3's additive inverse is 2 because it is the 0. So 3 plus 2 is equal to actually 5. If it is modulo divided with 5, you get the 0. So it satisfies the inverse property also. So here addition operation satisfies all the 5 operations. All the 5 operations. Now come to the whether this Z5 set, that's why set for multiplication operation, whether it satisfies all the properties or not. So consider this one. Now, already you know what is the Z5. Already you know Z5 is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, apply the closer property, check the closer property, or associativity property or anything. So if you check the closer property, for example, if you multiply 2 into 4, these two elements from Z5 is equal to 8, 8 mod 5 8 mod 5 is equal to 3. So 3 is in the same, 3 is the element of the Z5. That's why it satisfies the closure property. Similarly, it satisfies the check the associative property, whether it is satisfying this associative property or not. For example, 1 into 2 into 3 is equal to 1 into 2 into 3. Both to the values are correct or not. For example, 1 into 2 into 3 is 6. 6 mod 5 is 1. So answer is 1. Now 1 into 2 is 2. 2 into 3 is 6. 6 mod 5 is 1. So it satisfies the associative property. Similarly, it satisfies the inverse property. How to check the inverse property? How to check the identity property? Since for multiplication, the identity element is 1, if you multiply any element with the Z5, you will get the same element. So it satisfies the identity property. Finally, we are checking the whether this multiplication satisfies multiplicative inverse property or not for that purpose. So you should know what are the multiplicative inverses for the elements in the Z5. So what are the elements in the Z5? 0, 1, Z5 is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the elements of the Z5. Now, you should know what are the multiplicative inverses for these elements. Multiplicative inverses for this step. For that purpose, we will generate another table, that is the multiplicative inverse table, that is denoted with the Z5 star. How to get this table? Here also you have considered 0 to 4 as columns, 0 to 4 as rows, and multiply each one. So 0 multiply with any element, you get all the zeros here. So, and one multiplication with these values, you get these values. Actually, okay, if you multiply 2 with these values, okay, 2 into 0, 0, 2 into 1, 2, this 2 into 2, 2, 4, this 2 into 3, 6. But 6 mod 5 is 1, this is the 1, and 2 into 4 is 8. So for 8 mod 3, 8 mod 5 is 3. Okay. Similarly, after multiplying these values, you are getting these values. So in this table, wherever the 1 is there in the table, so those rows and columns are the multiplicative inverses. So for example, for 1, the multiplicative inverse is 1. So this is the pair. For 2, the multiplicative inverse is 3. This is another pair. For 3 also, the multiplicative inverse is 2. So this is the pair. For 4, the multiplicative inverse is 4. Okay. Now check. Multiply any element from this Z5, consider any value. For example, consider 3 from Z5 into its multiplicative inverse. 3's multiplicative inverse in Z5. 3's multiplicative inverse in Z5 is 2. So multiply its 3 inverse. That is nothing but 2. So 3 into 2. You should get the 1 here. Actually, 3 into 2 is equal to 6. 6 mod 5 is equal to 1. That's why. So it satisfies the inverse also. After multiplying any number, for example, A, with its inverse, you should get the 1 finally. So here in the Z5, I am trying to multiply the element of one of the element of Z5, 3, with its multiplicative inverse. So 3's multiplicative inverse is 2. So I am trying to multiply 3 into 2. equal to 6, but mod 5 is 1. So finally, it satisfies the multiplicative inverse. So here, the ZP, the residue, the set of residues of the prime number satisfies the all the properties on the addition operation and the multiplication operation. So finally, ZP it can be considered as a field structure. Field structure. Now come to the some other definitions. We should know the definition of the finite field. What is the meaning of the finite field? Finite field means if any field contains a finite number of elements, that means fixed number of elements. If any field contains a set with a finite elements, that field is called finite field. So a finite field with the finite number of elements. The finite fields are usually called, Galois fields. Galois fields. These finite fields are usually called as the Galois fields. Galois fields. It is denoted with GF of P power N, where P is the prime, N is the degree. So as per the Galois field is noted with GF, that GF is Galois field. P power N means P power N elements, that Galois field contains P power N elements where P is a prime number. Consider always the P should be the prime number. So how to denote the Galois field? A Galois field can be denoted with GF of P power N, where P power N means that the field contains P power N elements where P is the prime number, any prime number. Now, what is the GF of P field? It is nothing but if the N value equal to 1, if the N, this N value equal to 1, if the N value is equal to 1, then that is the GF of P. So GF of P means where N is equal to 1. So it contains, this is called, when N is equal to 1, this is called GF of P only, GFP field only. This field can be the set, this field can be the set Z. This field can be the set which contains, any set Z which contains the values from 0 to P minus 1. For example, P is the prime, if P is equal to 5, that means it is the, that field is called GF of 5. GF of 5. So it should contains 5 elements from 0, those are the 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 0 to 4. So if P is the 5, it should contain the 0 to 5 minus 1, that is equal to 4. 0 to 4 elements. 0 to 4 elements. So GF of P field contains P elements from 0 to P minus 1. Now, here, it should satisfies the addition operation. It on this set, on this field, or on this set of values, we can perform the addition operation and multiplication operations. So here, if it is addition operation, the identity element can be considered as 0, and if it is the multiplicative inverses, so consider all the non-zero elements, all the non-zero elements in the as the multiplicative inverses. Okay. Now example for the GF of P field. For example, consider P is equal to 2. Prime number P is the 2. Now GF, that is the noted with GF of 2. So GF of 2 means it contains only the two elements from 0 is one element. What is another element? 0 is one element. What is another element? It should be 1. So it should be less than the 2. Less than 2 means it is 1. So GF of 2 means it should contain the two elements. Two elements means one is the 0, another one is the 1. So GF of 2 contains a set. It contains a set with the values 0 and 1 only. And we can perform the two operations on these two values. We can perform addition operation on these two values, and also we can perform multiplication operation on these two values, 0 and 1. 0 and 1. Now consider this field structure as like this, GF of 2. It contains a set of 0 and 1 elements. And we can perform the addition operation, and we can also perform the multiplication operation. So see the addition operation and multiplication operations. So by using this table, so this is the addition table. So what are the elements of this GF2? First element is 0, second element is 1. So the take these two values as rows and columns. So this 0 and 1 column, and this 0 and 1 row. Now if you try to add 0, 0 is 0, and 0, 1 is 1, and 1, 0 is 1, 1, 1 is 0. Why 1, 1 is 0? Why 1, 1 is 1 plus 1? Actually, 1 plus 1 is 2. But it should be modulo divided with 2. So 2 mod 2 is equal to 0. So don't be confused. Here 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 0. But this 1 plus 1 is 0. How to get this 0 here? Very simple. This 1 plus 1 is actually 2. But since this is the prime number 2, 2 mod 2, residue 2, 2 mod 2 is 0. So this 1 plus 1 is 0, not 2. It is 2, but after mod dividing with 2, it becomes 0. So this is the addition operation. Similarly, consider the multiplication operation. This 0 and 1 are the rows and columns, multiply these values. So 0 into 0 is 0, 0 and 10 is 0. And 1 into 0 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1. So this is the multiplication operation. Now, if you consider the addition, if you see the addition operation, it gives the, it is same as the addition operation, is same as the exclusive OR operation. So as per the exclusive OR operation, what is the exclusive OR operation? If the both the values are same, you will get the 0. If both the values are different, for example 1 0, you will get the 1. If it is 1 0 or 0 1, you will get the 1. If it is 1 1, it is 0. That means in the both the bits, if the both bits are same, the answer is 0. The both the bits are different, I mean 1 0 or 0 1, you will get the 1 here. So addition operation is same as to the exclusive OR operation, and the multiplication is same as to the AND operation. AND operation means whenever the both values are ones, then only the answer is 1. That means 0 multiplied with 0, 0 multiplied with 1 is 0. 1 multiplied with 0 is 0, but 1 multiplied with 1 is 1. So it is similar to the AND operation. Now come to the whether the this field, this set satisfies additive inverse and multiplicative inverses. So additive inverse for A 0 is 0. Actually, 0 inverse is minus 1 as per our knowledge. But 0's inverse is 1, 1's inverse is 0. That is general concept. But here, since it is the GF2, that means Z2, since this table is Z2, as per the Z2 table, suppose if it is the Z2, so what is the additive inverse table 0101. So already we have the additive inverse. Yes, here we have the additive inverse. So here, wherever the zeros are there, those column rows are the additive inverses. So for 0, the additive inverse is 0. So for 0, the additive inverse is 0. And for 1, the additive inverse is 1. So for 1, it is 1, not 0. For 1, the additive inverse is 1. Only for 0 it is 0, for 1 its additive inverse is 1. Now check the multiplicative inverse. So as per this table, wherever we have the 1, that row value has the multiplicative inverse. So actually this 0 here, in this 0 row, there is no 1. So 0 doesn't contains the multiplicative inverse. That's why if the A value is 0, there is no A inverse for the 0. So it is the dash, there is no value. If the A value is 1, that means if A value is 1, its additive inverse is 1. For 1, it is 1. So it satisfies the multiplicative inverse. So this is the addition table, this is the multiplication table, this is the additive inverse table, this is the multiplicative inverse table. Now come to the another field called as the GF 2 power n. Actually, our Galois field is GF p power n. P power n. But it is GF 2 power n, where we are using GF 2 power n field. What is the GF 2 power n field? Actually, GF 2 power n is a finite field with the elements 2 power n elements. That's it. This is the finite field with the 2 power n elements. 2 power n elements. For example, if n is equal to 3, if the n is equal to 3, that means 2 power 3. This set contains, if you assume these all are the binary digits, if the word size is 3, then it should contain the 2 power 3 words with the combination of the zeros and ones. Those are 0000, this 001, 010, up to 111. Totally 9 combinations are there. If n is equal to 2, by using these 0 and 1, so we have the 4 values. We have 4 types of sets, 2 square values. They are 00, 01, and 10, and 11. So this is the GF 2 power n. GF 2 power n is a finite field with the 2 power n elements in this set. Now, why GF 2 power n is using in the computers? Why this field structure is used? Generally, if you know the computer stores positive integers as n bit words. It can store any positive integer number as n bit binary digit, n bit words. Generally, the word size can be 8 bit word or 16 bit word, 32 bit word or 64 bit word. As per the computer architecture, the binary digit words, the words, the combination of bits, binary digits are called as the words. The word size is 8 bit word, 16 bit word, 32 bit word, 64 bit word. So all the positive integers are stored as 8 bit word or 16 bit word or 32 bit word or 64 bit word in the computers. Okay, suppose if you use GFP structure for storing these positive integers, if you use the GFP, there is some problem where GFP means P is the prime number, P should be the prime number. So the GFP with the set ZP means it should contains 0 to P minus 1 words only. 0 to P minus 1 words only. For example, bit size is 3, word size is bit n equal to 3. That means word size is 3 means actually it should contains the 2 power 3 means 9 words, 9 combinations. So 9 combinations means the positive integers can be represented with the 2 power n means, which are 0, 1, 2, up to the 8, 0 to 8. 0 to 8 means, consider these values, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, up to this one. So these are the 0 to 8. If it is the 2 power n, it can store represent all the numbers from 0 to 8. But if you follow the GF of P field, that means since P is the prime, the P value is the largest prime number which is less than 2 power n. That means since n is equal to 3, so less than the largest prime number below the 2 power 3, that means 9 is 7. So the P value is 7 only here. You can take the P value as 7. So GF of 7 means here it can accept only the 7 values, 7 numbers from 0 to 6 only. This format, this field is not GFP field, is not supporting the integers 7 and 8. It is insufficient for accepting positive integers 7 and 8. But if you use GF of 2 power n field for representing these words, so 2 power 3 means 8 elements. The elements in this set are n bit words. So since n equal to 3, this set is 0001, 001, 010, up to 9. So consider all the all the positive integers from 0 to 8 here. Since it is the 9, since there are 9 elements, 9 words, we will take 0 to 8 values, all the elements, all the positive integers. So all the positive integers can be represented by using GF 2 power n field structure only. If you consider the GF of P field, this is not support for storing some of the numbers after this prime number to 2 power n elements, 2 power n minus 1 elements. Some of the, it is not suitable for representing some of the integers, this structure. That's why we are using GF of 2 power n to store the positive integers as n bit words in the computer. So this is the about GF 2 power n field. Yes, 2 power n field. So altogether, this is the field structure. This is the field structure. Field structure means which contains a set of values. On this set, we can perform addition operation and multiplication operation. Both addition and multiplication operations should satisfy all the 5 properties of the algebraic structures. Example for the field is R. R means a set of real numbers. Another example for the field is ZP. ZP means set of residues of the prime number. These are the 2 examples for the fields. We have the finite fields and Galois fields means, Galois fields means which contains P power n elements where P is the prime number. GF of P field means here if the n equal to 1, then there is only P elements in that field. GF 2 power n field means it contains 2 power n elements. Generally, this field structure is useful to represent the positive numbers. If you try to store or represent the positive integers using the GF of P structure, this field is not supporting to store some of the integers, which is after exceeding the P primary number. Prime number P. After the prime number, it is not accepting those values. If you use the GF of 2 power n elements, it supports all the positive integers in that bit, in that word size, that n bit word size. This is the class. Okay, thank you.